this. It's feral. No, it's not. It's not. Someone put it on weird.
Somebody else.
This is this is Grace Farrell. This is Grace Farrell, private secretary to Oliver Warbucks.
The millionaire?
No, the billionaire. He asked me to remind you to turn off your cell phones during the performance. Also, stay in your seats during the whole performance. If you need to use the restroom, please do so during the applause of songs.
Pardon me, Toots. Let me take it from here. There will be an intermission halfway. Water, cookies, cupcakes will be sold. Please eat them in the hallway. Save them for later. Also, keep small children with you at all times and keep them quiet, or we'll make them disappear, if you know what I mean. If you have any valuables and need someone to hang on to those for you, I could probably give you a hand.
Rooster, shut up! And actually, that goes for all of yous. Please don't talk during the show.
Yes, Miss Hannigan.
Crummy orphans, enjoy the show.
Thank you.
said, shut your trap, Molly.
Stop shoving the poor kid. She ain't doing nothing to you.
She's keeping me awake, ain't she?
No, you are.
Am not.
Are too.
Am not.
Ah, you think you're Jack Dempsey or something, do ya?
And you're looking for a knuckle sandwich.
Oh my goodness, they're fighting. I won't get no sleep all night. Oh my goodness.
Pipe down, all of ya. Go back to sleep.
Mama, Mommy.
It's all right, Molly. Annie's here.
It was my mama, Annie. We was riding on the ferry boat. She was holding me up to see all the big ships. Then she was walking away waving, and I couldn't find her no more. Any place.
Look, it was only a dream, honey. Now you gotta go back to sleep. It's after 3 o'clock.
Annie, read me your note.
My note again?
Please.
Sure, Molly.
Here it comes again. Ugh.
Please take care of our little darling. Her name's Annie.
October 28th, we'll be back to get her soon.
We have left half a silver locket around her neck and kept the other half.
So that when we come back for her, you'll know that she's our baby.
Oh my goodness, now they're laughing.
All right, do you want to sleep with your teeth inside your mouth or out?
Gee, I dream about having a mother and father again, but you're lucky. You really got them.
Maybe far away, or maybe real nearby. He may be pouring her coffee. She may be straightening his tie. Maybe in a house all hidden by a hill. She's sitting playing piano. He's sitting paying a bill. Bet you they're young. Bet you they're smart. Bet they collect things like ashtrays and art. Bet you they're good. Why shouldn't they be? Their one mistake was giving up me. So maybe now it's time. And maybe when I wake, they'll be there for me, baby. Maybe.
Good night, Annie.
July.
Good night, Annie.
Good night, Duffy.
Good night, Annie.
Good night, Tessie.
You in a cellar again.
I don't care. I'm getting out of here.
Okay.
Going now. Wish me luck.
Good luck, Annie.
So long, Dumbbell. And good luck.
Aha! Caught ya. I hear ya, Brad. I always hear ya. Now get up! I said get up!
Yes, Miss Hannigan.
Rotten orphan.
I'm not an orphan. My mother and father left me and I'm saying they loved me. And they're coming back for me.
That was 1922. This is 1933. Ha! They must have got lost in traffic. You in here! Get up! I said get up! It's medicine.
You must be very sick.
Boo!
Boo!
Now for this one, shenanigans. You'll clean them floors and strip them beds for the laundry man.
But it's 4 o'clock in the morning.
Yes, I know. And then you'll get down on your knobby little knees and clean this dump till it shines like the top of the Chrysler Building.
Yes, Miss Hannigan.
Now get to work, all of you. Why any kid would want to be an orphan, I'll never know.
It's a hard knock life for us. It's a hard knock life.
Numbered. All right, breakfast.
Hot mush?
No, you don't get hot mush today.
Yay! Yay!
You get cold mush.
Yay! Oh. And after your breakfast, you go to your sewing machines. There's an order of dresses due, even if you have to work straight past midnight.
Yes, Miss Hannigan.
Now go, all of you, get out.
Laundry.
Move,
laundry,
move,
man.
Move.
Morning, bundles.
Morning, kids. Clean sheets once a month, whether you need them or not.
Morning, bundles.
Oh, yeah, Aggie. Running a little late. See you in January.
Oh, get over here, you big handsome brute. Don't you want to know what I got you for Christmas?
What?
Egg Foo Young in Chinatown for two on me.
Egg Foo Young for Christmas?
All you can eat.
So what'd you get me?
What did I get you last year?
Nothing.
Good. You're getting it again.
Get out of here with the damn laundry.
Okay. So long, Aggie. And Merry Christmas.
Yeah, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, kids.
Merry Christmas, Bundles!
Annie, you call this place clean? This place is a pigsty. Annie, where's Annie?
Annie ain't here.
What do you mean, Annie ain't here?
She just went. With Bundles in the laundry bag.
Bundles? Police! Police!
No more hard knock life for Annie.
Lucky if she's out, they're free.
Running free in NYC.
Bet she finds her folks like that. Mom and dad right off the bat. Lucky duck, she got away.
But we're gonna have to pay.
Gonna get our faces slapped. Gonna get our knuckles wrapped. It's a hard knock life.
Yes, it is.
Did they hurt you? They're after you, ain't they? Well, they're after me too, but I ain't gonna let them hurt you or me. I'll take care of us, and everything's gonna be fine for the both of us. Not today. Well.
The sun will come out tomorrow. Bet your bottom dollar that tomorrow there'll be sun. Just thinking about tomorrow clears away the cobwebs and the sorrow till there's none. When I'm stuck with the day that's gray and lonely, I just stick up my chin and grin.
Hey, you, little girl, come here.
Yes, officer?
That dog there, ain't I seen him running around the neighborhood? Ain't he a stray?
A stray? Oh, no, officer, he's my dog.
Your dog, huh? What's his name?
His name is Sandy, right, because of his nice sandy color.
Sandy color? Okay, let's see him answer to his name.
You mean when I call him?
Right, when you call him by his name, Sandy.
Well, you see, officer, I just got him, and sometimes...
Call him.
Here, Sandy, here, boy, Sandy, Sandy, good Sandy, good old Sandy.
Well, maybe he is your dog, but the next time you take him out, I want to see him on a leash and with a license, or else he goes to the pound and they put him to sleep. You understand?
I understand, on a leash and with a license.
Good. Now get along with you before you catch your death of cold in this weather.
Oh, I don't mind this weather.
Thank you.
I'm stuck with a day that's gray and lonely. I just stick up my chin and grin and say, oh, the sun's come out tomorrow, so you gotta hang on till tomorrow. Come what may, tomorrow, I love ya tomorrow, you're always a day away. Tomorrow, I love ya tomorrow, you're always a day
Right, that's all the fresh air you get for the month.
Miss Hannigan.
What?
You know your favorite shiny satin souvenir pillow from Coney Island?
Yeah.
Molly threw up on it.
Ugh! You, what do you got there?
Nothing.
What do you got there?
A dead rat. Want to
see it? Get out of here, all of you.
Once again, we bring you the romance of Ellen Trent, who sets out to prove for herself what so many women long to prove, because a woman is 35 or more, romance in life may not be over. That romance can live at 35 and after.
Oh, merciful God, I hope so. Yeah?
Good afternoon. Miss Hannigan, is it?
Yeah.
I'm Lieutenant Ward, 17th Precinct. We found your runaway. You.
Annie. Girls. Guess what?
What?
There's ginger snaps and hot cocoa in the recreation room.
What recreation?
Oh, shut up. Get out. Thank you so much, officer.
She was in one of them Hoovervilles down by the docks. Had a mangy mutt with her, too. But he got away.
Oh, the poor pumpkin out in the cold with just a thin sweater. I hope she didn't catch influenza. Thank you so much, officer.
All in the line of duty. And you, don't ever let me hear again that you're in again. Room this nice lady.
She's not.
Good afternoon.
I'll have you head for this. And the next time you come out of here, it'll be 1953. Well, are you happy to be back?
Yes, Miss Hannigan.
Liar! What's the one thing I always taught you? Never tell a lie. Well, what's the one thing I always taught you?
Never tell a lie, Miss Hannigan.
For what you've done, I could have gotten fired, had the Board of Orphans sticking their noses in here. But you'll pay. I promise. Yeah? Stay.
Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan?
Yeah.
Oh, good. I'm Grace Farrell.
So?
And the New York City Board of Orphans suggested
Hold it. I can explain everything. You see, it was Annie's fault who got into Mr. Bundle's laundry bag, and then...
Miss Hannigan,
and I know I should have called Mr. Donatelli instead of the police, but I just didn't know what to do, and then I
Miss Hannigan, I'm sorry, but I haven't the slightest idea to what you're talking about.
Wait a minute. Hold it, sister. If it's beauty products you're peddling, I don't need them. Get out.
Miss Hannigan, I'm not peddling anything. I'm private secretary to Oliver Warbucks.
The Oliver Warbucks? Love the hat. You know, I read in Winchell's column that Oliver Warbucks is the richest unmarried man.
I wouldn't know. I don't read Mr. Winchell. Miss Hannigan, Mr. Warbucks has decided to invite an orphan to spend the Christmas holidays at his home.
An orphan?
Yes, an orphan.
You sure he wouldn't want a lady? I got 2 weeks coming. That was a joke. What kind of orphan are you looking for?
Well, she should be friendly and intelligent.
Mississippi, capital. MISSISSIPPI, Mississippi.
And cheerful.
Shut it! And how old?
Oh, age doesn't really matter. Say 8 or 9? 10. 11? Yes, 11 would be perfect. And oh, I almost forgot. Mr. Warbucks prefers curly-headed children.
11, curly hair. No. We don't got any orphans like that around here.
What about this child right here?
Oh, Annie? Oh, you wouldn't want her. She's a drunk and a liar. She's a drunk and a liar.
Yes, I'm sure she's a drunk and a liar. Annie, come here. Annie, how would you like to spend the next 2 weeks at Mr. Warbucks' home?
I would really love to.
Hold it. All right, you can have any orphan in this orphanage, but not Annie.
And now, why would that be?
I just told you.
I assume, Miss Hannigan, that this has something to do with all that business with the laundry bank and the police. Perhaps I should call Mr. Donatelli at the Board of Orphans.
All right.
Sign it.
All right, I'm an easy gal to get along with. If it's Annie you want, it's Annie you'll get.
It's Annie I want.
Then it's Annie you'll get.
Oh, boy!
So, if it's just a little coat, I'll take her right along.
Coat? She ain't got no coat.
All right, then we'll buy her one.
I'm getting a coat.
We'll go to Bergdorf's and get you a nice warm winter coat.
I can hardly believe it.
She can hardly believe it.
Come along, dear. Mr. Warbucks' limousine is waiting outside.
Bye, kids. I'm getting up for Christmas. I'll write to ya.
Bye, Annie.
Bye,
Annie. Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan.
Get out.
Prohibition
Good afternoon, Miss Farrell.
Good afternoon, Drake. Everyone?
Miss?
Has Mr. Warbucks arrived yet?
No, miss. His plane from Chicago landed at 3:30, so we're expecting him any minute.
Do you really live here, or is this a train station?
We really live here.
Oh, boy!
Mrs. Greer?
Yes, miss?
Has the carpet been put down in the dining room, Miss Greer?
Yes, miss.
And has the Steinway been tuned?
Yes, miss.
Everything is in order. Miss, Mrs. Pugh, has prepared his favorite dinner.
Wonderful. Wonderful. And? Fine. Yes, 6 weeks is a long time. Now, would everyone come here for a moment, please?
Everyone, quickly, quickly, everyone.
Everyone, this is Annie. She'll be with us for the next 2 weeks for Christmas.
Miss?
Annie, this is everyone.
Hi, everyone.
May I take your coat, miss?
Will I get it back?
Of course, dear.
Gee, Miss Farrell, I just really love my new coat.
I'm glad, dear. Now, Annie, what would you like to do first?
Oh, I'll get to the forest, and then I'll scrub the windows and—
Oh, Annie, you have to do any cleaning while you're here.
I won't?
Of course not. You're our guest, and for the next 2 weeks, you're gonna have a swell time. Now, Cecile will pick out all your clothes.
Green is her best color. No, blue, I think.
Your bath is run by Mrs. Green.
Bubbles. No soap, I think.
Annette comes in to make your bed.
The silk. No, the satin sheets, I think.
I think I'm gonna like it here.
Annie?
The swimming pool is to the left.
In the house? Oh, boy!
The tennis court is in the rear.
I've never even picked up a racket.
Have an instructor here at noon.
Yes, miss.
Oh, get the dumb butch fellow if he's available. I think I'm gonna
like
it. When you wake, ring for Drake. Drake will bring your tray. When you're through, Mrs. Pugh, please do take it away. No need to pick up any toys.
That's okay, I haven't got any anyway.
Aww. No finger will you lift, my dear.
We have but one request. Please put us to the test.
I know I'm gonna like it here. Used to room in a tomb where I'd sit and freeze. Get me now, holy cow! Could someone pinch me, please? Ow!
She didn't mean it.
We've never had a little girl.
Never had a little girl. We never had a little girl.
I'm very glad to volunteer.
We hope you understand. Your wishes are command. We know you're gonna.
Welcome. What? Been away for 6 weeks. Where is everybody? Hello?
Welcome home, Mr. Warbucks.
Welcome home, Mr. Warbucks.
It's good to be home.
How was your flight from Chicago?
Not bad. It took 17 hours, and we only had to land 8 times. Now, first things first. Has a plane arrived from Paris?
Yes, sir. They're just about hanging now, sir.
Ah, yes. No, I don't think so. Grace.
Yes, sir?
Messages.
Yes, sir. President Roosevelt, he wants you to call him at the White House.
I'll get him back tomorrow. Anything else?
John D. Rockefeller, Mahatma Gandhi, and Harpo Marx.
Nothing urgent. What did Harpo want?
He didn't say.
Oh, wait a minute. Maybe I can learn to live with this thing. Hand us a place.
Yes, sir. Mr. Warbucks, I'd like you to meet the orphan.
Oh, and Miss Pugh.
New England clam chowder.
Wonderful.
Kentucky fried chicken.
Wonderful.
Idaho.
I won't be having dinner tonight. I got hours of paperwork to get through.
Look at page.
And Grace, I need you for dictation.
Yes, sir.
All right. It's good to see you all again.
Sir.
Drake.
Yes, sir.
Mr. Staff.
Yes, sir.
All right. Grace, if you just get your notebook in. Who is that?
This is Annie, Mr. Warbucks, the orphan that will be spending Christmas with us.
The orphan? But that's not a boy. Orphans are boys.
I'm sorry, sir. You just said orphan, so I chose a girl.
Oh, well, I guess you have to do. Annie, huh? Annie what?
Sir?
What's your last name, child?
Oh, I haven't got a last name, sir, Mr. Warbucks, that I know of.
So you're just Annie, huh?
Just Annie. I'm sorry I'm not a boy.
Well, I don't suppose you'd like to meet Babe Ruth.
Oh, sure. Who is Babe Ruth?
I couldn't be happier that you would be spending Christmas with us. Grace, we'll start with the figures and our new shipment from Toledo to... What are we supposed to do with this child?
It's her first night here, sir.
Oh, it is? Well, Annie, your first night here? Then I guess we ought to do something special for you. Why don't you sit down? So, would you like to go to a movie?
Oh, sure. I've heard all about them, but I've never been to one.
Never?
No, sir.
Well, then we got to do something about that right away. And nothing but the best for you, Annie. You go to the Roxy, then ice cream soda for Rumpelmeyer's, then Hansom Cab Rider around Central Park.
Golly!
Grace, forget about the dictation for tonight. We'll do it first thing in the morning.
Yes, sir.
Instead, you take Annie to the movies.
Yes, sir.
Aw, gee.
Something the matter, Annie?
Nothing, just... Aw, gee.
No, what is it, child? You don't want to go to the Roxy?
No, it's just I thought you were going to take me, Mr. Warbucks.
Me? Oh, no. I'm afraid that I'll be far too...
Aw, gee.
Annie, I've been away for 6 weeks, and when a man is running a multi-billion-dollar corporation, that has a lot of...
No, gee. I understand.
Drake!
Yes, sir?
Coates.
Yes, sir.
And Grace, you come too, of course.
Yes, sir.
Will you be wanting the Bentley, sir, or the Duesenberg?
The Duesenberg.
Excellent choice, sir.
No, wait. This child's been cooped up in the orphanage. No, Duesenberg. We'll walk.
Walk to the Roxy?
Sure. Why not? It's only 45 blocks.
Yes, sir.
Ah, smell that. Fifth Avenue bus fumes. There's no air like the air of New York. And don't really realize how much you missed it. The whole city, until you've been away for a while. Just like the man says, after New York, every place out is Bridgeport. NYC, what is it about you? You're big, you're loud, you're tough. NYC, I go years without you, then I can get enough of cab drivers answering back in language far from pure, enough of Frankfurters answering back, brother, you know you're in. NYC, too busy, too crazy, too hot, too cold, too late, I'm sold again on NYC. Come on, you slow pokes, we need to get to the Rocky before the prices change.
NYC,
the shadows of sun.
In the rundown, the big parade goes by. What other town has the Empire State and a mayor 5'2"? No other town in the whole 48 can have compared to you. Oh, NYC, you make him a postcard. You crowd. You're still the champ, amen, for NYC.
The shimmer of Times Square.
the forest, the beach, the drive.
You might say that I'm square, but there I come alive. The city's bright as a penny arcade. It blinks, it tilts, it rings.
My voice, my shame, you can't explain. There yet, for
I see, just got this morning, bucks, two bags, me. And why see, I give you fair warning, of I'll be go west. The Gershwins are coming in hearts, the place they love the best. Though California pays big for their art, their fan mail comes addressed to NYC. Tomorrow a penthouse that's way up high.
Down there.
Immediate seating. There is immediate seating.
Popcorn? What is this on popcorn? I haven't had popcorn since.
Give in, don't fight. Good girl, good night. Sleep tight.
And now CBS Radio brings you Ma Perkins. Ma's daughter Faye is going to marry Carl Michaels. On Friday, Carl went back to Chicago.
Oh, Carl, don't go back to Chicago.
But no sooner had Carl left town than Dr. Andrew called to stop him.
Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan.
Ah, Farrell, you're early, only 1 week. What's the matter? Warbucks already fed up with Annie?
Oh, no, on the contrary. Mr. Warbucks is delighted with Annie, and Annie is having the time of her life.
How nice.
Oh, yes. They are practically inseparable. They go everywhere together. To the Roxy, to the Stock Exchange, and Chris, they had lunch yesterday.
The Waldorf.
The Automat.
The Automat?
I know you're busy, but this has to be sent signed and sent back to Mr. Donatelli.
That bug's mine.
Sent back to Mr. Donatelli no later than 10 a.m. tomorrow morning.
Oh yeah? What for?
Mr. Warbucks is so delighted with Annie that, guess what?
What?
He wants to adopt her.
Oh my, how nice, how wonderful. Let me get the wonderful news straight. Annie is going to be Warbucks' daughter, the daughter of a millionaire.
Oh no, no, no. The daughter of a billionaire.
Would you excuse me for a moment?
I'm a bit red here.
You got any more wonderful news?
I told you about the coat, didn't I?
Oh, you told me about the coat.
Well then, good day, Miss Hannigan.
Yeah, good day.
Oh, and season's greetings.
Yeah, season's greetings.
Pardon me, Toots. Hiya, sis. Long time no see. Yeah.
Rooster, oh God, it never rains, but it pours. They finally let you out of Sing Sing?
I got 6 months off for good behavior.
Oh yeah? What was it this time?
Some old geezer from Yonkers said I swindled him out of $1,100.
Well, why'd he say that?
Because the rooster swindled him out of $1,100.
Ah, Lil.
It's true.
Sis, I'd like you to meet a friend of mine from...
Jersey City.
Give us a tip.
Jersey
We're
City.
Really hard.
Lily St. Regis.
I'm named after the hotel.
Oh, yeah? Which floor?
Mm-hmm.
Come on, sis.
Yeah.
Can it, Rooster?
I'm just sitting there
Looking
trying to
Looking for another handout?
Nah, I got $80 coming in the mail Thursday. So all I need is a 10 to tide me over.
Uh-uh. Not even a nickel for the subway, Rooster.
A fiver, Aggie?
$5? I gotta laugh. You and your big talk gonna be living in clover.
Well, this ain't exactly Buckingham Palace.
Oh, yeah? I'm on the city. Steady salary, free food, free gas and electric. I'm doing all right.
Sis, you're doing like I'm doing.
Lousy.
Oh, Aggie, how'd the two Anakin kids ever end up like this? On the skids. I remember the way our sainted mother would sit and croon us her lullaby.
She'd say, kids, there's a place that's like no other. You gotta get there before you die.
You don't get there by playing from the rule book.
You stack the aces.
You roll the dice.
Mother dear, oh, we know you're down there listening. How can we follow your sweet advice?
The toots I bumped into when I walked in. Looked like she had a couple bucks.
She works for Oliver Warbucks.
The Oliver Warbucks? The millionaire?
No, the billionaire, you dumb hoe.
Hey.
She works for him up in his mansion on Fifth Avenue.
Fifth Avenue? He don't live on Fifth Avenue.
No? Well, where does he live?
Easy Street. Street, where the rich folks play,
where they play
did that dame want?
Brought me the wonderful news that Annie, one of the orphans here, God, I hate that kid, is getting adopted by Warbucks. The rotten kid is gonna have everything.
Crummy orphan living in the lap of luxury. It ain't fair.
No, it ain't fair.
It ain't fair how we scrounge for 3 or 4 bucks. She gets Warbucks.
The little brat.
It ain't fair, all this life is driving me nuts. While we get peanuts, she's living fat.
Maybe she holds the key, that little lady,
to getting more bucks
instead of less. Maybe we fix the game with something shady.
Where does that put us?
Oh, tell her.
Give you one yes.
Yes. Easy Street. Easy Street. Annie is the key.
Yes, sirree, yes, sirree, yes, sirree.
Yes, yes, yes. Mr. President, no, I'm not asking for your help. I never asked for any man's help, and I never will. But I'm telling you that you gotta do something about this right now. All right, talk about it on
Friday.
All right, Friday, at the White House. Goodbye, Mr. President, why don't we bury the hatchet, and you come over here with Mrs. Roosevelt for supper, Christmas Eve on your way to Hyde Park. Good, I'm delighted. Goodbye, Mr. President. If I thought I was going to say yes, I never would have asked him. Grace, call out Smith and find out what Democrats eat.
Yes, sir.
The package from Tiffany's?
Arrived this morning, sir.
Fine. I'm going to give this to her and tell her that I want to adopt her. Where is Annie?
She's upstairs, writing another letter to her friends at the orphanage. I'll have Drake call her down.
Fine. Damn!
No need to be nervous, sir. Annie is going to be the happiest little girl in the world.
Don't worry, she is. I'm not nervous. Annie, get her down here!
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Oh, hello, Annie. How you doing today?
Fine. How are you doing, sir?
Fine. Annie, it's time for the two of us to have a very serious discussion.
You're sending me back to the orphanage, right?
Annie, can we have a man-to-man talk?
Sure.
I was born into a very poor family where they call it Hell's Kitchen, right here in New York. My parents died before I was even 10, and I made a promise to myself. One day, one way or another, I was going to be rich, very rich.
That was a good idea.
By the time I was 23, I made my first million. Then in 10 years, I turned that into 100 million. Boy, in those days, that was a lot of money. But then I realized something. No matter how many Rembrandts and Duesenbergs you got, if you have no one to share your life with, if you're alone, you might as well be broken back in Hell's Kitchen. You understand what I'm trying to say?
Sure.
Good.
Kind of.
Kind of?
I guess not.
Damn! I was in Tiffany's yesterday, and I got this thing for you.
Gee, Mr. Warbucks, you're so nice to me.
I had it engraved. It's a silver locket, Annie. I know it's that old broke one you always wear, and I said to myself, I'm gonna get that kid a nice new locket.
Gee, thank you very much, Mr. Warbucks.
Here, we'll just take off the old one off it.
No, no, please don't make me take my locket off. I don't want a new one.
What is it, Annie?
My mother and father left me this locket when they left me at the orphanage, and there is a note too. They're coming back for me, and I know being here with you for this Christmas, and I'm really lucky. It's just, I don't know how to say it. And one thing that I want more than anything else in all the world is to be like all the other kids with folks of my own.
Annie, it'll be all right. I'll find them for you. I'll find your parents.
It's gonna be okay.
I'll get her a brandy.
Annie is gonna be just fine.
Miss Annie, if you see, you just see, if there's anyone who can find your parents, Warbucks is the man.
If he has to pull every political string there is to pull, up to and including the White House.
The League of Nations.
Annie, give me a locket.
But Mr. Warbucks, I just told you.
I understand, but it could be our best clue. We have the FBI trace what was bought and find out who bought it.
Oh, okay. Maybe they should have my note too.
Just you watch, Annie. You might be meeting mother and father within a couple of days.
Really?
Really.
I've got to go write a letter to the kids. And Mr. Warbuck says I might be meeting my mother and father within a couple of days.
We will now take a 10-minute intermission. Attention, 2 minutes before we start Act Two. 2 minutes before Act Two. Thank you. Attention, 1 minute until start of Act Two. 1 minute until start of Act Two.
Thank you, Annie. Thank you. On America's favorite radio program, The Occident Hour of Smiles, starring your old softie, Bert Healy. A moment of tears. Say something.
Thank you, Bert Healy.
But still, remember, folks.
Smile, Darnya, smile.
Right, Wacky. Smile, Darnya, smile. Say, Wacky, who's that that just walked into our WEAF studio?
Why, it's none other than the wealthy, industrious, and Wall Street tycoon, Oliver Warbucks.
Now, Oliver Warbucks, I understand that you have something to tell the folks at home about wonderful little Annie here.
Yes, good evening, Bert Healy. Annie is 11-year-old foundling who was left on the steps of New York's municipal orphanage on the night of December 31st, 1922.
And aren't you now conducting a coast-to-coast nationwide search to find Annie's parents?
Yes, Bert Healy, I'm now conducting a coast-to-coast nationwide search for Annie's parents. Drop page. Furthermore, I'm offering a certified check for $50,000 to anyone who can prove that they are Annie's parents.
Wow!
Wow! So, Annie's parents, if you're listening in, write to Oliver Warbucks, care of this station, WEAF, New York, or directly to him at...
I'm a home, Bert Healy. Oh, at my home! At my home, Bert Healy, 987 Fifth Avenue, New York, New York.
That's 987 Fifth Avenue, New York, New York.
And I'd like to take this opportunity to thank the makers of all new Oxydent toothpaste with Miracle L64 to fight bad breath for letting me appear this evening. And I just did a commercial. Great, I never talked to the product in my life!
Good
this is
night,
the most
Oliver Warbucks! Thanks for stopping by, Oliver. So, Annie's parents, if you're listening in, there's $50,000 and a wonderful daughter waiting for you. So get in touch right away, you hear?
Hey, Mr. Healy, isn't it time once again for the lovely Boylan sisters?
It most certainly is, Wacky. Well, I can see by the old clock on the wall that another of our Thursday night get-togethers have gone by faster than you could say Oxydent.
O-X-Y-D-E-N-T.
The toothpaste of the stars.
To make your teeth Hollywood bright.
So for the Hour of Smiles family, Ronnie, Bonnie, and Connie, the lovely Boylan sisters, Fred McCracken,
and Wacky.
This is Bert Healy saying ha-ha-ha-ha. Hey, hobo man, hey, dapper dam. You both got your style, but brother, you're never fully dressed without a smile. Thank you. Your clothes may be bold, romerly. They stand out a mile, but brother, you're never fully dressed without a smile. Who cares what? What you wear from ear to ear, and not from head to toe, that matters.
So
senator,
so
janitor,
so
long for a while. Remember, you're never fully dressed without a smile.
Ready or not, here he goes. Listen to Bert tap his smiling toes.
The lovely Boylan sisters.
Your clothes may be bald, probably. They stand out a mile, but brother, you're never fully dressed without an S-M-I-L-E small target.
Yes, this is your old softie. This is Healy's boy, Bert. Saying until next week, same time, same station. Monsoon, Buenas noches. Bon Sarah. Gosh, I almost forgot. Good
that
night.
Matters.
Holy cow. Annie on the radio.
Coast to coast.
She's famous. Thank you. Thank you. I wish I was on the radio.
Me too.
Nah, not me. Who wants to be on the dumb old radio?
I do.
Hey, hobo man, hey, dapper Dan, you both got
not your style, but rather you're never fully dressed without a smile. Your clothes may be broke, they stand out a mile, but rather you're never fully dressed without a smile.
Who cares what they're wearing on Main Street or Central Row? It's what you wear from ear to ear and not from head to toe.
That matters.
Ah, the lovely Boylan sisters.
So senator, so janitor, so long for a while. Remember, you're never fully dressed without a
happiness in here.
No, Miss Hannigan.
What are you doing up so late?
Annie was on the radio.
Yeah. I heard. And the next thing you'll know, they'll make a musical about her. Now get out, all of you. Go on.
Mama, Miss Hannigan, Miss Hannigan.
Say it! Ow! Oh, she never misses. Oh.
You can't live here.
A $50,000 reward? Oh, gee, what I couldn't do with $50,000.
Excuse us, ma'am. We knocked upstairs, but nobody answered. Are you the lady that runs this here orphanage?
Yeah.
Oh, Ralph, I'm scared. Something could have happened to her.
Oh, Shirley, it's going to be all right, Cheryl. She's going to be here, and she's going to be ours again. Ma'am?
What do you want?
Well, we had terrible troubles back then. We had to head north to Canada. Had to leave our baby here on the front stoop.
Our little girl, our Annie.
Wait, your Annie's parents?
Oh, please, nothing's happened to her.
Where'd you say you were from again?
A little farm up in Canada.
Manitoba.
Where they got lots of chickens.
Little chickens.
And ducks.
Ducks.
And geese.
Oh, you should see all the geese.
And roosters!
Gosh, oh, rooster, I never would have known it was you in 100 years.
Fool Jaggy. We're gonna fool Warbucks, too.
Get ourselves 50,000 big ones.
This is gonna be the best bunco job ever, Aggie. I know a guy out of jail that can doctor up a fake birth certificate or any other papers you might need. But we're gonna need your help for details about Annie that can help us pull this thing off.
I could help ya. I could help ya a lot. But what's in it for me, Ralph?
Three-way split, Aggie.
Half.
Half?
Half!
Half! Half, 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 straight down the middle. 25 grand each. But we gotta do it fast, Aggie. Give them some of the old rooster razzle-dazzle. In, out. 2-3 minutes at most. Get the money, get the kid, and get the hell out of town.
Yeah, the kid, Annie. That's the problem. What do we do with her afterwards?
Aggie, that is no problem.
When the rooster wants something to disappear, it disappears.
For good.
Rooster!
Come on, Aggie. We get the 50 grand, we blow this crummy town, and then Lil Emil meets ya.
Oh yeah? Where?
Easy street, easy street. Annie is the key.
Yes, sirree, yes, sirree, yes, sirree.
Easy street, easy street.
President Roosevelt has lived up to none of his lofty campaign promises. All we have had from Franklin Delano Roosevelt and his so-called brain trust.
Brain trust
is a great deal of a high phone talk and virtually no action. An nation wrecked by poverty, misery, and unemployment. It is deeds you want from the White House, not words. In short, Mr. President, if you are listening, we've had enough of your fireside chats. It's time to...
Criticism, darn it! Nothing but criticism!
I know.
It's awful.
Did anyone see the Washington Post this morning?
My friends, I say again, the only thing we have to fear is fear itself.
Franklin, you've already been elected.
Every cloud has a silver lining. You're never fully dressed without a smile.
Oliver Warbucks and friend Franklin.
Thank you, Louie. Show them in. Oh, Oliver, good of you to have come.
Come on, Mr. President.
Well, who's this we have here?
Mr. President, this is my good friend Annie.
Annie?
She's so wanted to meet me too that I couldn't resist bringing her along, just to say hello.
Of course, the little girl who sang so beautifully on the radio last night.
How do you do, Mr. President?
How do you do, Annie? You're as lovely as you sound on the radio.
Thank you.
Well, shall we begin?
Annie, you just wait on...
No, Oliver. Let Annie stay. Having a child on her hands will keep us on our best behavior.
Oh, thank you, Mr. President. Annie?
Harold, I don't want to hear so much as a gosh out of you.
Franklin, a child?
Now, Oliver, since you speak for those happy few Americans with any money left, I'd like to begin with your views on matter.
Mr. President, in the words of Calvin Coolidge,
The business of this country is business.
Yes, and for the good of you, this country... Wall Street and me, we've got to get my factories open and the workers back to work.
According to my latest figures, there are now 50 million Americans out of work and nearly 50 million with no visible means of support.
Mr. President, if I may say so, unemployment is not our worst problem. The dispatches from Germany are becoming more and more disturbing each day. There could be war.
Germany? Heck, people are starving in this country.
Harold, I know that, but in the long run, we're not.
Cordell, for people who are starving, there is no long run.
The problem is it's all happening at once. Has taken another nosedive.
Sit-down strikes, riots,
floods, dust storms.
And the FBI still hasn't caught Al Capone. Well, at least we're all agreed on one thing. Situation is hopeless and getting worse.
Henry, you like to see those figures?
The sun will come out tomorrow. Bet your bottom dollar that tomorrow they'll be...
Quiet, little girl.
Harold. What did you say, Annie? No, that's all right. Go ahead. It's still a free country. Harold Ickes, stand up.
What?
You heard me. Stand up. Up, up, up. Now, Harold, sing.
Sing?
Yes, sing. Like Annie, I decided that if my administration is going to be anything, it's going to be optimistic about the future of this country. Now sing.
But really, Franklin, you know that I...
Sing.
The sun comes out tomorrow.
Louder, Harold.
Bottom dollar that tomorrow there'll be sun.
Perkins.
Just thinking about tomorrow. There's a way the cobwebs and the sorrow.
Stuck with a day that's gray and lonely. I just stick up my chin and grin and say, everyone, all of you, sing.
Oh, the sun come out tomorrow, so you gotta hang on to tomorrow.
Telegram.
Yes. Excuse me, everyone. This isn't for me. It's for you, Oliver, from your secretary in New York. Hundreds of couples jamming outside house, all claiming to be Annie's parents.
Oh, boy!
Have begun to screen them. Suggest you return to New York at once. Signed, Grace Farrell.
Well, it looks as though the Hour of Smiles has more listeners than we thought. Hi, Annie.
Gee, hundreds of couples? One of them's bound to be my mother and father.
Well, Oliver, I suggest you return to New York immediately.
Yes, Mr. President. If you don't mind, Annie.
Bye, everybody.
Bye, Annie.
Goodbye, Mr. President, and thank you.
No, thank you, Annie. You're the kind of person a president should have around him.
Mr. President, what if we set up 1,000 federal projects? Yes.
Highways.
Yes.
Post offices.
Yes, and put the unemployed to work building them.
We can create 6 million new jobs within 6 months.
And weekly paychecks, we get those million off relief and back to paying taxes.
We could build a country so strong that nobody, including Chancellor Hitler, could defeat us in war.
Mr. President, what we've got to give this country is nothing less than a new outlook.
A new vision.
A new approach.
A concept.
New dedication.
A new attitude?
A new deal! My friends, I say again, the only thing we have to fear is fear itself.
Miss Farrell, I'm afraid there's still no sign of Mr. Warbucks and Miss Annie.
Drake, look at all these questionnaires. Do you realize that I've interviewed 617 women who have claimed to be Annie's mother and 619 men who have said to be her father? That makes, let me see.
1,236.
Oh, liars, Drake. I never realized that there were this many dishonest people on the island of Manhattan.
Some were from the Bronx, miss.
Grace, we're back!
Where are they, Miss Farrell?
people.
They're gone, dear. Come and gone. I'm so sorry, Annie, but they were all liars and fakes after nothing but the $50,000.
Are you certain?
Yes, sir. None of them knew about the locket. I'm so sorry.
Mr. Warbucks, this has just come by special messenger from the FBI.
Ah, finally. Elliot Ness has located a manufacturer of Annie's lockets in Utica, New York.
Oh, boy!
That sort of locket was manufactured between 1918 and 1924.
Sort of locket?
Yes. Over 90,000 were made and sold.
90,000?
Annie, I'm afraid that the gist of it is Ness doesn't think there's a chance in a million of tracing your parents through the locket. I'm sorry.
Gee, I thought somebody was going to be my mother and father. I mean, you didn't turn out so bad. You got everything. And all them Duesenbergs hanging on the wall.
Excuse us, sir. We'll go check on the dinner menu.
Annie, a Duesenberg's a car, and Babe Ruth is a right fielder for the New York Yankees. And there's something else you should know. I've made me a fortune, that fortune made ten. The headline and profiled again and again. But something was missing, I never quite knew. The something was someone but who? My speeches were greeted with thunderous acclaim, with two universities bearing my name. Yes, something was missing each time I got through. That something was someone but who? That someone be, how could she make it known? Who would need me for me, need me for me alone? The world was my own. But where was the pearl who dreamed I would find it in one little girl? Yes, something was missing, but dreams do come true. Not bad for an old man, huh? Grace! Grace! Do you still have those legal papers I gave you the other day?
Yes, sir. Right away, sir.
No, wait. I want you to stay for a moment. Annie, I want to adopt you.
Adopt me?
Yes or no?
If I can't have my real mother and father, then there's nobody in the world I'd rather have for father than you, Mr. Warbucks.
Drake!
Yes, sir?
Call Justice Brandeis and ask him to come over to sign those adoption papers.
Yes, sir.
And Grace?
Yes, sir.
We need flowers.
Flowers.
Caviar.
Caviar.
And champagne.
Champagne. I'm fine.
Annie, this isn't just going to be adoption. This is going to be a celebration. If you have anyone in the world who you'd like to come to it, who you like? Babe Ruth? John Rockefeller?
I mean, I guess I'd like Miss Farrell and Mr. Drake and Mrs. Pugh and Miss Greer and Cecile and Annette. I mean, I guess I'd like everyone.
Of course. That's who I like too. Drake!
Yes, sir?
Tell the staff to get spiffed up. The groomy to guess is at Annie's adoption party.
Yes, sir.
Oh, and the kids!
Oh, no. It'll be way past the bedtime. But I'll tell you what. We'll have everyone from the orphanage here tomorrow for a big, huge Christmas party.
Miss Hannigan, too?
Miss Hannigan, too. Why not?
Excuse me, sir. Everyone is getting ready for the party.
Good. I guess Annie and I should get ready as well. Grace!
Yes, sir?
Have the seal put Annie... Wait, Grace, that's a very pretty dress.
Why, thank you, sir.
Have the seal put Annie into one of her new dresses and have Sis Anna do something with her hair. I don't know. Gather her up.
Yes, sir.
Annie, I'm the luckiest man in the world.
And I'm the luckiest kid.
Together at last.
Together forever.
We're tying a knot.
Never can sever.
I don't need sunshine now to turn my skies to blue. I don't need anything but you. You can say that again.
Yesterday was quite awful.
But that's
not now.
That's then.
I'm poor as a mouse.
I'm richer than Midas.
But nothing on earth could ever divide us. And if tomorrow I'm an apple cider too,
I don't need anything.
I don't need anything but you.
What?
Sir. Excuse us, folks. We don't mean to interrupt. Charlie, look, there's our Annie.
Who are you?
Honey. We're your mom and dad.
Mudge. Mudge is the name. Ralph Mudge. And you this year, the wife Shirley.
You never knew it, dear, but you're Annie Mudge.
Annie Mudge?
We was sick and broke, honey. We didn't know which way to turn. Then a man gave us a chance to work on his farm up in Canada.
And we couldn't bring along no baby.
We loved you, Annie, but we had to leave you behind.
Mr. Mudge, is it? We've seen a great number of people today who have claimed to be...
Proof! I expect you'll be wanting proof of who you are. Here's Annie's birth certificate.
Baby girl, name, Anne Elizabeth Mudge, born to Ralph and Shirley Mudge, New York, New York, October 28th, 1922.
October 28th? That's my birthday.
Is it a note, sir?
Yes, I know, but I still don't...
Mister, please, you've gotta believe us. We got in on the Greyhound this afternoon and went straight to the orphanage to pick up our Annie. The lady said that she was up here.
Oh, Annie, how I've dreamed of holding you in my arms again.
Mr. Mudge, on the night that Annie was left at the orphanage...
Oh, here's something you wouldn't know about. When we left Annie at the orphanage, we left half a silver locket with her, so that one day...
Ralph, look! She's wearing it!
And here's the half that we kept. Yes, it fits perfectly.
Oh, thank God, Ralph. She's our Annie.
She is. She is.
She seems to be.
Well, if you'll be getting her things together, then we'll be taking her along.
Take her?
No!
Just a moment. Mr. Mudge, what about the money?
Well, we ain't got much, but we'll be glad to give you whatever.
So you haven't heard that I offered a certified check for $50,000 to anyone who can prove that they are Annie's parents?
No, sir. We don't know nothing about no check. We don't want no money anyways.
Right. We don't want no money for Annie.
On the other hand, Cheryl, remember that little pig farm out in New Jersey? With $50,000, we could buy it outright. Afford to raise Annie upright in the country. Fresh air, fresh eggs.
Fresh ham.
Fresh ham. Certified, eh? All I gotta do is make it out to myself.
Yes, that's correct. Tomorrow morning.
Tomorrow morning?
Yes. Do you wouldn't mind if Annie stayed here until tomorrow morning Christmas? Then you come back to grab Annie and the check.
Oh.
Oh.
Problem?
No. It's whatever you prefer, sir. Well, we ought to head back to the hotel now. Goodbye, Annie. Until tomorrow morning, honey. Then you'll be spending the rest of your life with us.
Goodbye, Annie. Love.
Oops. Pardon us, Toots. Merry Christmas.
Season's greetings, one and all.
Well, this is wonderful news.
Yes, wonderful.
Annie has found her parents, and they seem to be a very nice couple.
Yes, very nice. Annie, you're lucky.
Right. I'm lucky. Just think. A pig farm.
Miss Greer? Champagne?
Yes, sir.
We must celebrate, because it's Christmas Eve, and we just had the most wonderful news in the world. Annie has found her mother and father. Everyone, I propose a toast. To Annie Mudge.
To Annie Mudge. Annie!
I lost Annie.
Sir, that Mr. Mudge, I think I've seen him someplace before, but I just can't remember when or where. But I have the strangest feeling he's not who he says he is.
I won't know until he's certain. I'll go straight to the top, to the President of the United States, even if he is a Democrat. Thank you, Grace. Could I never have... Oh, Merry Christmas, Annie.
Merry Christmas, Annie.
Merry Christmas, Mr. Warbucks. Miss Farrell.
You're up early.
Well, yes, I bet my folks will be taking me, so I just thought I'd get up here and wait for them. You're up early.
We've been up all night, dear, and we had quite a time of it. Have my men coming and going. Annie, do you know that President Roosevelt is here?
Really?
I have something very difficult to tell you, and the President is going to help me tell it to you.
Merry Christmas, Mr. President.
Merry Christmas, Annie. It's good to see you again.
It's good to see you, too.
Franklin?
Annie, earlier this morning, FBI Director Hoover telephoned me with some very sad news. Through the paper and handwriting in your note, they finally succeeded in tracing the identity of your parents.
Yes, we know, Mr. and Mrs. Mudge.
No, Annie, they aren't your parents. Your parents were David and Margaret Bennett.
David and Margaret Bennett? Where are they?
Annie,
your parents passed away a long time ago.
You mean they're dead?
Yes, dear.
So I'm an orphan, after all.
Annie, are you all right?
Yes, because I guess I always knew my folks were dead, because they loved me, and they would have
killed me. I love you, Annie Bennett.
And I love you, too. Now, who the heck are Ralph and Shirley Mudge?
Atta girl, who the heck are Ralph and Shirley Mudge?
The birth certificate could have easily been forged, but the thing is, they knew about the locket.
The locket, that's your key.
But nobody knew about the locket except us, and the FBI, of course.
And Miss Hannigan.
And Miss Hannigan.
And Miss Hannigan.
Miss Hannigan, sir, and the children from the orphanage.
Oh, Miss Hannigan, I'm delighted to meet you.
Me too. You're the Oliver Warbucks, right?
That's right, Miss Hannigan. Let me introduce you to everyone. You know my secretary, Miss Fair, of course.
Of course.
And this is the President of the United States.
Okay.
And this is my butler, Drake.
Hi, kids.
Hi, Annie.
Look, kids. There's Christmas presents for all of us under the Christmas tree.
Wow!
Mr. Warbucks, this has just come from the FBI.
Good. Come to dawn! Everything makes sense now!
Annie, come look at this.
Leaping lizards! Who would have guessed?
Show it to the President!
Sir, Mr. and Mrs. Mudge?
Show them in, Drake.
Yes, sir. Won't you please come in, Mr. and Mrs. Mudge?
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
And Merry Christmas, one and all.
Merry Christmas.
Merry, 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 Merry.
Thank you, Drake.
Christmas.
Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad.
Hi, Annie. Love.
Well, we don't want to bother you on Christmas and all. We just came to get Annie. Her suitcase.
Oh, allow me.
And, the check.
Yes, of course. The check. I almost forgotten. Here it is, Mr. Mudge. $50,000 certified.
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 Pay to the order of Ralph Mudge.
Read it again.
Pay to the order of... The jig is up.
That's right. The jig is up, Daniel Francis Hannigan. Also known as...
Rooster Hannigan, also known as Ralph Mudge, also known as Danny the Dip.
Bye, Mom. Bye, Dad.
Franklin, I believe that fraud is a federal offense and that your secret servicemen have the power to arrest.
Yes, Oliver, they certainly do. Drake, please turn them in.
Yes, sir.
And arrest her too, please.
Oh, me? I didn't know them till yesterday.
Come off it, Aggie.
Yeah, sis. If me and Lilith take it a fall, then so are you.
Oh, please, Annie. Tell them how nice I always was to you.
Gee, Miss Hannigan, but remember the one thing you always taught me?
Never tell a lie.
Brat, I'll let you know a little secret. I never liked you, little gold digger, and I never liked the rest of you either.
You, your days are numbered.
Let me at her! Let me at her!
Annie, we'd like to meet your friends.
This is Miss Grace Farrell.
Hi, kids.
Hi.
And this is Mr. Daddy Warbucks.
Hello.
Hi, kids.
And this is the President of the United States.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi, kids.
Children, Miss Hannigan is gone for good.
Woo!
And you do not have to work anymore.
Woo!
Instead, you have classrooms and teachers.
Yeah!
But no. Guess what, kids? No more mush!
Look who I found outside.
Aw, Sandy!
Finley.